In this video, we define an exponential function and graph the following three functions. This is the definition of an exponential function. A function of the form f of x equals b to the x is called an exponential function, where b is greater than 0 and it's not equal to 1, but the exponent x can be any real number. Now, this is a little bit different than how you usually think of exponents. For instance, so far we've done things like 3 squared, remember that means 3 times 3, or we've done things like 3 to the negative 1, that would be 1 over 3, right, to the positive 1, and we've done things like this, 16 to the 3 fourths, remember that was the 4th root of 16 cubed, or 8. Well, in all of these cases, the exponents are rational, right? They're either fractions, or they're whole numbers, or they're negative whole numbers, or they could be negative fractions. But now I'm saying x can be a real number. So we're expanding our notion of what the exponent can be. The other thing to pay attention to is the base, b, cannot be 0 or 1. In fact, the base has to be greater than 0, so it cannot be a negative number, and it's going to exclude the number 1, because 1 to any power is going to be 1. So we're going to begin with graphing some exponential functions. All right, let's graph f of x equals 2 to the x. Now, remember, you could think of that as y equals 2 to the x. So we're going to put in some values for x. That's going to be the exponent. So how about some positive numbers and some negative numbers? So let's try negative 2, negative 1, 0, 1, and 2. So that means f of x, or y, would be 2 to that value of x. So that's 2 to the negative 2. Now, we have to simplify that. That means 1 over 2 squared, which is 1 fourth. All right, how about 2 to the negative 1? That one's easier. It's 1 over 2, so that's 1 half. 2 to the 0, oh, remember anything to the 0 power except is 1, unless it was 0 to the 0 power. We're not even going to talk about that right now. And 2 to the first power is 2. And 2 squared is 4. And imagine as these numbers get bigger, I'm just going to get bigger and bigger numbers. So let's graph these 5 ordered pairs and see if you kind of could connect the dots to get a picture of what this would look like. So go ahead and put your video on pause and try that on your own. All right, now notice the way I've drawn my graph. I notice that the y values are always positive because I'm taking some number, right, a positive number raised to some exponent. It can't be negative. So that's why I don't have any tick marks underneath the x-axis. So let's do this. We've got the order pairs negative 2, 1 fourth. Well, I don't know, that's about right here, approximately. We've got negative 1, 1 half, so negative 1 and then up a half. We've got the point 0, 1. We've got the point 1, 2. We've got the point 2, 4. All right, well, what would be, let's say I put in 3, what would that be? If I put in 3, that'd be 2 cubed, or 8. So if I go to 3, it's up to 8. And boy, if I went to 4, it would be up at 16. It's going to get really big. Now imagine if I put in even smaller numbers in for x, I would still have a tiny number. It would be 1 over 2 to some number. So like 1 over 2 to the 10th would be 1,000th. It would still be above the x-axis. So if I actually connect the dots here, I get a graph like this. Which, notice, not only is it a function, but it's a one-to-one function. It passes the horizontal line test. I can't really draw to the left here, this arrow going much lower, but you get the idea. It just gets closer and closer to the x-axis, but it goes on forever and ever. What would happen if we wanted to graph y equals 5 to the x? So in other words, that would be the function f of x equals 5 to the x. Go ahead and put the video on pause and see if you can get an idea of what that would look like. All right, what would happen here? Let's just do a couple points. When x is 0, I'm still going to get the same point here, 0, 1, right? So I'm putting that in green. But when x is 1, all right, So x is 1. What's y? It's all the way up at 5. So when I go over 1, I'm all the way up here at 5. When x is 2, it's up at 25. I can't even show that on this graph, so I could see this is going to be really steep. What's happening over to the left? How about if x was negative 1? What would 5 to the negative 1 be? That would be 1/5. It would, instead of being at 1/2, it would just be lower. So this picture here is it's lower down here, and it gets steeper. But it looks kind of the same. So if you drew yours more accurately, if you did a few more ordered pairs, yours should look similar to mine. Notice on the right side of the y-axis, the green, that's y equals 5 to the x, is steeper. But on the left of the y-axis, it's lower. It's closer to the y-axis. I'm sorry, closer to the x-axis. Said that wrong. All right, so we had the red was y equals 2 to the x. And you can imagine y equals 3 to the x is somewhere in between there. All right, let's do another one. Let's say we were graphing y equals 1/2 to the x. So notice the base is positive, but it's not equal to 1. So this is an exponential function again. So put the video on pause and put in a few values for x and figure out what y would be. I'm going to, again, just use some positive and negative values. So if I have 1/2 to the negative 2, now there are different ways you could figure this out. When I have something raised to a negative exponent, it's the reciprocal, or 2, to the positive exponent. You might have figured out that the answer was 4 some other way, but that's what 1/2 to the negative 2 power is. How about 1/2 to the negative 1? That's actually 2 to the first power, or 2. How about 1/2 to the 0? Anything to the 0 power. Almost any number anyway, to the 0 power is 1. 1/2 to the first power is 1/2. And 1/2 squared, 1/2 times 1/2 is 1/4. So these are 5 ordered pairs, and then we can do a rough sketch of this. So I've plotted these 5 ordered pairs, and let's say we put in 3, we're going to get 1/8, so this would be like really low over here, or if I put in negative 3, what would happen is we'd have up here at 8 somewhere. So you get the basic idea again that it looks kind of like that other one. Oops, my hands are a little shaky. Okay, except notice it's up high over on the left. So when this base here was smaller than 1, notice it's really high over on the left. So let's look back at the previous page. Remember how it looked? That's y equals 2 to the x, the red line. And now we're going to look at y equals 1/2 to the x. See how it's going down, sort of like a mirror image in a way across that y-axis. So when this base, 1/2, actually is less than 0, it sort of switches. It's descending. All the numbers are getting smaller, right? All the y values are getting smaller as x is getting larger. One more little interesting note, 1/2 to the x could be written as, well, 1/2 is really 2 to the negative 1, right? So that could have been written as 2 to the negative x. So you might have been given the problem y equals 2 to the negative x, and that's actually the same as 1/2 to the positive x. It would end up looking the same. So there are different ways of writing the same thing, right? So if you're given y equals 2 to the negative x and plugged in values, the same values for x, you would get the same values for y, and your graph would look exactly the same. So you could practice with some more graphs. Just pick different values for the base. Try some numbers where there's a minus in front of the x if you want, or not. And we'll be doing some more things with exponential functions on the next video.